Welcome to Defender's Voice. This is Dr. Paul. Thank you for joining us today. Please visit our website. Please send your questions to info@drpaul.org. Our website has more information on our ministry, so visit our website. Subscribe to my podcast. Today's question is, Nathan says, false evidence was planted on Ravi's phones. Is it true? Were Ravi's digital devices targeted in a phishing attack? Excellent questions. Ravi Zacharias' son, Nathan Zacharias, posted a blog on his website. And he wrote that he went through his dad's phones and did not find any questionable or concerning photos. Nathan says that Miller and Martin misrepresented some of the innocent things that Ravi had on his phone. For example, he found a little bit further in thigh. A little bit further. There are no sexual connotations in that question. My dad was just giving instructions to the cab driver. Go a little bit further and turn right. That was the meaning of his instructions. Nathan says that Miller and Martin have dishonestly twisted those words into a sexual request. They blatantly misrepresented my dad. Why did they lie about the context of this note? What other information did they lie about, misrepresent, and manufacture? Nathan made a very serious charge against Miller and Martin in this post. Hopefully, Miller and Martin would respond to this charge. I do not take sides. I will go where truth leads us. As I said many times before, we should go where truth leads us. If Ravi was innocent, he should be acquitted. If Ravi was guilty, he should be condemned, and his victims should get justice. At least some monetary compensation. One of my friends is a law enforcement officer. He talks about evidence laundering. In evidence laundering, one police officer obtains evidence and passes it on to another officer who builds on it to charge the defender. The first officer obtains the evidence in violation of the Fourth Amendment. The Fourth Amendment states the right of the people to be secure in their persons, houses, papers, and effects against unreasonable searches and seizures shall not be violated. The Fourth Amendment gives U.S. citizens protection from unreasonable searches and seizures. That also applies to new technologies like BlackBerry's iPhones owned by Ravi Zacharias. Whether Ravi's civil rights were violated in the process should be investigated. His personal phones and computers were searched without his consent. Did any evidence laundering happen? Nathan is also saying that the evidence was fabricated to indict his dad. That also should be investigated. Did anyone plant photos of women, on Ravi's phones? Did anyone plant sexting messages on his phones? All digital fingerprints should be explored. All photos coming from one source or all photos coming within a few days? Are photos coming from after Ravi's death, that is suspicious activity. Those should be investigated. Sometimes people send unsolicited photos and messages. That is especially true for celebrities like Ravi Zacharias. I agree. That should be investigated. We should not be afraid of investigations. We are looking for the truth. Every defendant deserves a fair trial, especially in case of Ravi. We are talking about one of the most influential Christian leaders of our time. So he deserves a full investigation. You wrote, did phishing happen? For starters, phishing is a cyber tactic that involves dangling a bait in front of an unsuspicious user of the internet. Spear phishing is more dangerous. The name comes from using a spear to catch a particular fish. You attack one particular fish you are interested in catching. Spear phishing is getting very common in cyberspace. Was Ravi targeted in a spear phishing? were Ravi's phones and computers targeted in a spear phishing attack? That needs to be investigated. Nathan is making serious charges against Miller and Martin report. They should be further investigated and we should know the truth. So that is my answer to your questions. If Nathan wants more investigation, that should be done. Because investigation takes us to the truth and everybody would know the truth. As Jesus said, you shall know the truth and the truth shall make you free. Okay, folks, that's all for today. Please like this video, share your comments and thoughts on this, and God bless you.